What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to G-Mind's World. Today, we're going to be talking about a few things. Number one, the amount of collectibles you should have for your free. It could probably be a 98 overall, whatever it's going to be. You have an opportunity to be able to get a free player. Now, remember, this is a 16-week program. So I've been updating you guys as we go through it. So that way you can't say, oh, yeah, you never reminded us. I've been doing it every week, as I promised, because with the Madden 10, a lot of you guys are like, yo, G-Mai, can you do me a favor? Can you remind us weekly, stuff like that? I have no problem doing that, but if you guys miss it for whatever reason that it is, you can't blame me for it because I've been absolutely doing it. I admitted to, you know, to not, you know, giving you guys the information and dropping the ball with the Madden 10 and not reminding you, even though on the first week that it came out, I told you guys like, yo, please just continue to do it if you can. Remember, I had a business trip the weekend that Calvin Johnson free safety came out. For those of you guys that remember, I went to San Diego, and what happened was I flew back in and drove straight home and just barely made it for that final collectible for Calvin Johnson. So it was wild and savage, but we got it done somehow, some way. We were able to get that free card. But with this right here, some of you guys have already said that you missed it, but then some of you were saying they're gonna be releasing more Ultimate Legends, so maybe you would have a chance to get more afterwards. I don't know if that's the case. Some of you guys are leaving those comments that it did happen last year where you were able to actually go because they, you know, they continuously continue to release more Ultimate Legends. For me, I don't know what EA is doing. I don't know if that's confirmed, so I cannot say that. All right, so whatever you guys are reading about in the comments, unless somebody, you know, a representative from EA Sports says that it's confirmed that they're gonna have additional Ultimate Legend tokens, I am not sure if it will happen, okay? But all I can tell you is that you should absolutely, at this point right now, have 14. So the way that it worked, the first release was 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So in 2 more weeks, we will be able to get a random one out of all of them. And as you guys can see, a lot of the ones that are coming out now, they're 98 overalls. So we're gonna actually go take a look at some of them right now. So, you know, pretty much what I want you guys to understand is, you know, as far as the numbers go and the communication that we have here at G-Mai's World, you guys are very, very good with each other with releasing the information as it comes out. I just don't wanna say it myself because then you guys will blame me for it and I don't wanna have to deal with that. So I always try to make sure. If I tell you that I'm guessing, I will say in the video, it's a guess. If I guess that a player is gonna come out, I will always say I'm guessing. But this has not been confirmed that there will be additional tokens, even though some of the logic that you guys use, like, yeah, they're gonna be making more Ultimate Legends, so doesn't it make sense that there'll be more tokens? I don't know, because why would they let them expire then? You know, like, I don't know what EA is doing, bro. Listen, I can't, you know, justify whatever's going on, but it doesn't make sense. If it didn't matter, you see like how with the Madden 10 promo, you were able to go back and, you know, play it and get it. With this, they expire. So I don't know. I have no idea what they're doing and if they're gonna be more, but at this point, you should have 14 of the 16, all right, to get your free random career edition Ultimate Legend player, which could possibly be a 98 overall. So now, Ted Hendricks has been released, Randall McDaniel has been released, all right? We're gonna go take a look at that now and evaluate it based on the information that we know and what we feel that we can do. Are these players worth going after? Now, the left guard, Randall McDaniel, that dude's numbers were ridiculous. If you guys follow me on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and Twitch at G-Mai's World, you would have seen that I put out some snapshots about these legends being released today. So their numbers are outrageous. As a matter of fact, do I have, I gotta see what I have. Do I have, let me check to see something as far as having the power up for these players. I know I probably have a Ted Hendricks because I did so many of the cards, but I don't know if I have the other guy. No, I don't have him because he's a 77, right? Yeah, Randall McDaniel. I don't have that guy. We'd have to go buy him and see what's good with him. But I think we have the Ted Hendricks. So the biggest thing about Ted Hendricks is he's 6'7", right? So because he's six, wow, we got so many of them. Is he selling for a higher price? Like, what is he selling for? 18, all right, we can't do nothing with that. Like, bro, we got so many of that dude. All right, cool. All right, so look, this is the big thing. This picture looks completely ridiculous. Like, why would they use that picture? But look, we're not gonna, that's not what the video is about. We're not gonna go into that. But anyway, with this card right here, let's go check a look. Let's take a look at what he would become. Obviously, he doesn't have anything that he's really, really like, oh my God, he's good at it. But he's 6'7". And you know what that means in Madden? He's gonna warp dive and make your brain explode. Not only that, he gets 4 ability slots. That doesn't really mean anything for us because he plays on either edge, and we've already come to the conclusion that Warren Sapp is the god. All right, so he does get a gold 99, which a lot of you guys are extra excited about. So we're gonna go ahead and take a look at some of these numbers. 90 strength, that's not bad. I guess we would give him brawler. The 90 strength probably would help him get off certain blocks and stuff like that. But just looking at his card right now, there's a lot of lower numbers, but the awareness is high, tackle's high, which means that he's gonna give up every tackle that he's supposed to get. Impact blocking is high. See, that right there is a very dangerous number because the impact block defensively, he's getting off blocks. So he's pretty much gonna, if dudes are running like stretch and you just have him out there with no abilities, that impact block being that high, he's getting off that block and he's gonna put in work. Just so that you guys know that, he's gonna absolutely 100% put in work. I just wanna make sure we're very, very clear with that, all right? The power moves being 90, that's like what? And then the finesse moves 83, are you serious? His block shedding is 97. Injury, we don't really care about that no more because this is not the same Madden where dudes used to get hurt and we had to use injury cards, so that's all over. Play rec 98, you know, does that really matter? 95 pursuit, 97 block shed, zone coverage 78, hit power 94. So this is what I would suggest, right? Look, his block shedding is so high that you know that more than likely, if dudes are trying to just outright block him, he's going into the backfield anyway. Like, he's gonna be back there like, yo, everything's good? All right, I'm just here to say what's good. That's what he's going to do. Then he's gonna hit your brains out. See, look, he should be able to get technically Enforcer, right? With 94 hit power? I don't know, maybe it's 95 it could be 95. 95 hit power could be like the minimum or something like that. I don't know, but that 94 hit power looks kind of glitchy. But you could see that he doesn't really have anything that he's truly, truly good at other than the block shedding. And that's also weird because they should have given him 99 block shedding in like just straight final stat right here. It should show it right there. I don't know why they did it like this, even though he's going to probably be, well, he'll be a 98 block shedding on our team because of John Madden coach. But I don't think we use the other chem. We don't use the run chem. I mean, the defensive chem. With the pass rush, because pass rush doesn't give you block shedding, it gives you finesse and power moves. So he's a very basic card, you know, when you look at it, but because he's 6'7", I doubt that many people are going to be able to run to the outside on you. You know what I'm saying? Like, I already know there's going to be a psycho out there with this guy, and he's going to be making my life like just straight shambles, bro. I'm going to try to run a stretch. The dude's going to dive from in the parking lot, and he's going to tackle me. And I've played against him even when I thought he was trash, and that's what people did. You just click onto him and dive because he's 6'7", and his body's long. It's sort of like Julius Peppers. You know what makes Julius Peppers good? He's so tall. You know what I'm saying? So when you go for the warp tackle, it's gonna make it more enhanced. And I would say it would be ideal to user him, but it really isn't. So that would be a lie. Because with the way you would have to have abilities on him for him to jump, it doesn't matter that he's 6'7". You know, all that other stuff that's gonna happen. So, you know, the card, looking at the card itself, it's nothing fascinating about it, but you know, it's something that you guys could consider. Now look, this is what I'm gonna do. We're gonna go take a look at Kevin Green because Kevin Green, I believe, gets Enforcer. So what was Kevin Green's hit power? Because that's interesting that they only gave him a 94. Now, it depends on position and the archetype and all that good stuff. But, you know, this guy's a finesse dude. But, see, his hit power is 95. We would have to double check it. But more than likely, I would say, like, 99% chance, he would probably be able to get it. He would probably be able to get Enforcer, you know, for his archetype with Run Stopper. But I don't want to spend the training to kind of see if he does. You know what I'm saying? Like, yo, hold on. Like, do I need to do that? Like, this dude, more than likely, I'm just going to say more than likely he does. You know what, bro? You guys are going to ream me if I don't. So I'll just use it and then, you know, I'll use the training and see if he does get it. So that way we figure it out together. I don't want to deal with you guys because you guys go, oh, bro, yo, does he get it? Like, yo, bro, listen, I don't know. Like, okay, so hold on. Physical. All right, we go use a little bit. Okay, ability slot 1. Okay, so we use a little bit of training. Not a big deal. All right, what does he have here? All right, so this unlocks, oh, 90 hit power for him. All right, so he does get Enforcer. All right, so good luck for him, man. All right, cool. So that way, achieve 93 overall, achieve 90 hit power. So he gets it with his, what else would he get? He gets everything else, probably. Achieve 99 overall. So he gets inside stuff. He gets all that stuff, brought with a little bit more stuff. Okay. He doesn't get this though, because he doesn't go to 95 finesse move. But he gets run stopper and all that stuff. Achieve. Yeah. Once he gets it. So look, even this is what's interesting, right? You know, like how we know Jadeveon Clowney, even without abilities, he goes crazy because he gets run stopper. This guy might be the same way, which is kind of weird. Let me explain to you guys what's going on, right? So look, we took, for those of you guys that don't know, my veterans already know, so bear with me real quick as we let our new viewers understand what's going on with Madden Ultimate Team. Pretty much what happens, right? When your player is good enough to unlock certain abilities, even when they don't have the ability, they play sorta the way they would with abilities. Like Jadeveon Clowney can unlock Run Stopper. Even though he doesn't have abilities, when you run to his side, he's throwing the first guy down to the ground. It could be similar with him. Now remember, my finesse move guys, they don't have Run Stopper. Like Kevin Green doesn't unlock Run Stopper. So this guy getting it could be an issue on the outside. He could be a guy that would definitely make sure that nobody is running outside at all. Because once you unlock that, it's very, very difficult. Extremely difficult for anybody to get away with it. So you see like right here, he has to achieve 95 block shedding. And I don't think he gets that, right? Where's his block shedding at? Okay, 87. So he doesn't get that. So what he tends to do is spin off of certain things. Ted Hendricks will go right into the backfield. If that was the case, like he would just run right into the backfield on a block shed. And that's why when people run the ball to whatever side Jadeveon Clowney is, I know a lot of you guys have experienced that. Like, yo, he don't even have abilities though. Like, you guys understand what's happening, right? Because he can unlock it, he plays similar to that situation. So let me show you guys before we get into Randall McDaniel. And Emmitt Smith being the limited, we're not really concerned with him because we have Barry Sanders, but we'll go take a look at his card as well. So look, Jadeveon Clowney, right? He doesn't have abilities on him, but because he unlocks Run Stopper at final tier, the dude is a monster. So look, this is what happens, right? Right here, because where is he? Out of my way. What is going on? Oh, it's up here. Okay, so he unlocks this, right? So it's part of his card. So even when we took it off of him, if you watch what he does on the left side when they run the ball, his first move is to throw the guy out the way, not spin off like the finesse move players. He throws them off and he comes right in. Now, the other guy is just a straight run stopper because you look at the left side of his card with the line going through it. So he's ready to go. This could actually make the squad really OP. The bigger thing is this though. LT, when he's released, he's probably going to get all of this stuff. And we're going to probably, you know, obviously keep Jadeveon Clowney and not need Ted Hendricks. But if Ted Hendricks is really, really good and we tried him out, we could probably put him on the D line next to Sapp, who also gets Run Stopper. And it'll be more problems for your opponent because now he has to figure out like what is going on right now. Like, why am I not able to run the ball at all for any reason? That could be an issue. Just so that we're on the same page and everybody understands what's going on. You know, that with that type of archetype and being able to get outside and stop the run, that is very, very important. That's the reason that we stepped our game up here at G-Miles World a lot, because we got these players on the outside. So we don't really get run on a lot. Every now and again, somebody will break a run, but it's not often because of the players that you have on the outsides. All right. So that's, you know, pretty much where we are with, you know, Ted Hendricks. Will we go after him? I don't know. You know what I'm saying? It is what it is. Now what we're going to do, we're going to check out the running backs because we'll do the limited first. And then we got to go find, we're going to have to find Randall McDaniel's card because I've showed you guys, we don't have his power up right now currently. So look, this is what's going to happen with Emmitt Smith. And no, he doesn't have 99 agility. So I don't think he gets human joystick. Some of you guys were asking, does he get human joystick? I don't believe he does because his final tier is 97. And no. When you chem it up, you cannot unlock something that's on this final tier. Maybe in the future, EA will allow that, but the final tier, once you don't see it here, it cannot be unlocked. Also, in addition to that, you have to get a team that Emmitt Smith played for to get the additional speed, to kind of get him the 99 speed, because he will go to 98 with John Madden coach and Sprinter, Brawler, whatever you want to use, and then you have to have a Cowboys theme team, whoever else he played for, whatever, to get him up to that 99 speed using that. The similar way where I use a theme team with the 49ers, for those of you guys that were asking. So We don't really need to, like, it's nothing really fascinating about him. And it is, you know, mostly Cowboy fans that are going to go crazy about this card. But for me, I wouldn't get him at all for any reason possible. I know it's a 99 carrying and all that stuff, but again, human joystick, once you play with it, you know what I'm saying, bro? Like, okay, that sounded kind of weird, but the human joystick feature, what goes on with it, Barry said, like, until they make another running back with it, I'm done with running backs, pretty much is what I'm trying to say. So let's go over to, we're going to go over to Randall McDaniel. That dude's name, I don't know why I always think of Ronald McDonald when I think of that. Like, it's just so weird whenever I hear his name. But we're going to go and buy his power-up so we can look at his numbers. His numbers are absolutely insane. I'm going to let you guys know that right off the rip. It's completely and utterly insane. It makes no sense. All right, what's this guy? He's an ultimate legend right now. Where are you? Let's go here and see what you got going on. Why is he 20? Bro, dog. Seriously? Okay, let me go to team. Let me go to Viking. Yo, that, why is it that much, man? I guess because he's a gold 99 and people just being greedy. 15. All right, I'm not buying it. I'm not gonna buy it yet. I don't know exactly what's going on. All right, so the 98. Okay, about to say, like, why is it that much? All right, so 480 is about what he is. All right, so let's take a look and compare him to who we have currently. So Quentin Nelson, 99 strength. Now, see, this is where it gets crazy, and a lot of you guys are like, yo, G-Mai, that dude, like, I see why you got him. Quentin Nelson is very, very unique. You see how that's in green? Bro, you're not beating that. So even though Randall McDaniel is a gold 99, and I'm looking at his numbers, 98 run block, which goes to 99. Run block power, 96. That's similar to that, but he'll get the chems also. Pass block footwork. We could go into this and look at it too. Strength, 99. Agility is a little bit better for him. 81 speed, that's probably going to be a little solid. Awareness, hours is higher. Okay, catching and all that stuff. Who cares about that? Run block, 95 to 98. Pass block, he's not really, whatever. 96 for impact blocking, 99 for Quentin Nelson. Yeah, this is a no-brainer. Quentin Nelson stays. Even if we don't think that the run block power, not the run block power, but the strength and all that stuff, because remember, like I told you, strength in certain aspects doesn't matter as much as it did when the game was launched, and it's very, very freaky. When the game was first launched, strength was a huge factor. You would see it visibly. And then people started to complain about certain aspects of the game. And then EA ended up tuning a lot of the way that it worked. But Quentin Nelson is a dog. Like, this dude, once he blocks you, you're not getting off the block. You know, like how Lane Johnson, like a skinny corner with no biceps, will throw him to the ground? Quentin Nelson, that doesn't happen to him. Like, when he runs out in front, you're going for six. And it's pretty much what it is. So Randall McDaniel, even though he's a gold 99, I don't really like it as much. I would avoid it. You know, people are buying it up. That's great. But I would avoid it, absolutely, just to make sure. I don't really think that it's worth it. Now, let's go to Ted Hendricks, because he's a guy that we could probably give a shot to and see what he does from the outside. Now, if it turns out that he's garbage, it wouldn't really matter, though. You know what I'm saying? Like, it really, you know, it definitely would not matter. You can see that he's going to be a little bit cheaper for obvious reasons. People are not really looking for Ted Hendricks because he doesn't have anything spectacular. But I'm giving you guys the insight into why he could be a problem, because you can't run the ball. See, and when you can't run the ball because a dude has Ted Hendricks on one side and then on the other side he has Jadeveon Clowney at this point, it makes it very, very difficult for you to have that aspect of your game. You know what I'm saying? And because of his block shed, that also may be an issue. So I'm kind of intrigued to kind of see what he's all about, bro. I'm definitely intrigued to, like, see, like, yo, is this dude garbage, or, like, what is he doing? Does he suck at the game? Like, is he garbage now? Like, I know a lot of you guys are thinking the same thing as well. Like, is he really going to be out there balling though? And, even Kevin Green is just so much stronger, but his tackle is better, play rec. The block shedding is a huge thing though. But then you look at the finesse and the power move, and it's like, Kevin Green is just, like, without the block shed, you know, I don't know. But again, Ted Hendricks gets run stopper, and he's 6'7", bro. The dude is diving from anywhere on the field and tackling you, and I don't care what you say about it. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's really, really crazy. All right, you know, and remember, guys, it's a possibility that you could get these cards for free in 2 weeks. Just so you guys know, like, you know, it could be a free whatever. You know, 98, 97, EA is probably going to give us the lowest version, whatever, but it is a high possibility. The only thing that makes me kind of like, you know what, we should probably give him a chance is because we have Von Miller as our backup and the dude's garbage and we don't really want him on the squad. So I'm going to take a look at it, kind of figure it out, see what's going on, and then we'll pick up from there. All right, guys? But you guys can leave me your feedback. Let me know what you think. Are we trying out Ted Hendricks? What's really good out here in these streets? Let me know. I'm going to see you guys and girls next time. You have an unbelievable day. One love, y'all.